Good morning, veterans, honored guests, parade participants, and citizens of our wonderful city of Richmond. Your attendance here this morning is greatly appreciated. Please turn off or mute all electronic communications devices in order that the ceremony can be conducted without interruption.
Thank you.
The 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month marks the ceasefire or armistice ending the combat component of the Great War in 1918. Would you please rise and join the Richmond Community Band under the direction of Bob Mullett and vocalist Iris Chan for the singing of our national anthem.
Oh.
Today we remember all Canadians who've lost their lives in the service of our country, from the Great War, the Second World War, the Korean War, peacekeeping services, Afghanistan, and other services at home and abroad. We remember at this time as well police, firefighters, and first responders who too have given their lives in the service of our communities. Canadians continue to serve with honor in the name of peace around the world and in the defense of our great nation. On Remembrance Day, we recall with thanks the sacrifice of human life of more than 118,000 Canadian sons and daughters who have given their lives for us. As we remember our fallen soldiers, let us also remember the sailors who will never have a known resting place. Across the oceans where white caps blow, there are no crosses, row on row. We now invite the R.C. Palmer School Choir under the direction of Iris Chan to perform in Flanders Fields. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Remembrance Day marks the anniversary of the armistice ending hostilities in the Great War for Civilization in Europe. Many descendants of that Great War are in attendance here today. In those far-off killing fields in France and Belgium, orders were distributed exactly on this particular date and time. Frontline units heard the message that confirmed that they had indeed survived the greatest conflict that mankind has ever known. The order to Canadians came from Field Marshal Sir Douglas Haig, ending the fighting with these simple words: hostilities will cease at 1100 hours. 10:58 that morning, a Canadian soldier, George Price, ventured out from the safety of a brick wall near Mons and was shot to death by an enemy sniper. George Price would be the last of more than 60,000 Canadians to die in the Great War. 2 minutes later, the fighting was over and Canada grieved. Closer to home, Private Edward Williams lied about his age so that he could enlist in the Canadian Expeditionary Force in that Great War. He was at that time a 15-year-old Indigenous fisherman from Steveston. He made his way to the enlistment center in New Westminster and then lied about his parentage so that his mother and father could not track him down and pull him out of the service. But he succeeded in joining the Legion of Canadians engaged in battle in Europe. And through the events of war, he was assigned as an infantryman in the 7th Battalion that would storm Vimy Ridge on April 9, 1917. Edward and 15,000 Canadians went over the bags that morning. Edward took a gunshot wound in his left leg, shattering his femur, and laid on the battlefield for several days, long enough to develop gangrene. When he was eventually evacuated to Wimereux Field Hospital 5 days later, it was too late. Our dear 17-year-old son died of his wounds on April 14, 1917. He was too young to vote, but in any case, as an Indigenous Canadian, he did not have that right. Private Edward Williams' direct descendants are in attendance here today, and they have the full rights of all Canadians that a 17-year-old Steveston fisherman chose to fight for. Edward Williams is remembered on the eastern face of the cenotaph directly in front of the Veterans Platoon. Canada recognizes the Royal Canadian Mounted Police as part of our armed forces. A loss for the Royal Canadian Mounted Police is a loss for everyone in the military family and every Canadian. In October, Royal Canadian Mounted Police Constable Shaylin Yang was ordered to an assignment that would, through the course of duty, take her life. Constable Shaylin Yang enters the Legion of our glorious dead, along with Edward Williams and 118,000 Canadians who have given their lives in the service of our nation. May we live our lives in honor of their sacrifice and strive to live up to the courage and commitment that they showed us to live in a world of peace. Shaylin's family is in attendance with us today. They will never know the beauty of this place, see the seasons change, or enjoy nature's chorus. Yet all that we have, we owe to them, those brave men and women who lie buried in lands far away and here at home, and those courageous sailors lost forever at the bottom of the sea. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Their name liveth forevermore. Remembering them, let us pray. Lord God of hosts, be with us yet, lest we forget, lest we forget. We now invite His Worship Mayor Malcolm Brody, along with City Councilors Bill McNulty and Chak Ao, to lay a wreath on the cenotaph on behalf of His Majesty King Charles III. For the Government of Canada, Wilson Gao, MP for Richmond Centre, and Parham Baines, MP for Steveston and Richmond East. For the Government of British Columbia, Kelly Green, MLA for Richmond Steveston, Henry Yao, MLA for Richmond South Centre, Aman Singh, and Teresa Watt. representing Silver Cross Mothers, Sylvia Hart. Representing the descendants of Private Edward Williams, Cody Burnson and Doug Wilson. Representing the Richmond School Board, Deborah Toblotny and Heather Larson. For 39 Service Battalion, Lieutenant Colonel Ann Fort and Chief Warrant Officer Michael Morrison. From the Royal Canadian Mounted Police Richmond Detachment, Chief Superintendent Dave Chauhan. From Veterans Affairs Canada, Donna Twemlow. From the Last Post Fund, Captain Scott Edmiston. the Canadian Border Services Agency, Linnell Redmond. From the Royal Canadian Marine Search and Rescue Station 10 Regiment, Tatiana Pacheco. Representing Richmond Fire Rescue, Jim Wishlock, Fire Chief. Jim Dixon, President, Richmond Firefighters Local 1286. And Pat Gallican, Retired Firefighters of Richmond. Representing the Royal Canadian Legion Branch 291 Richmond, President Linda Snell. Representing the Army, Navy, and Air Force veterans in Canada, Unit 284 Steveston, President William Spencer. Representing the Army, Navy, and Air Force veterans in Canada, BC Provincial Command, Sharon Goshko. For the Royal Hong Kong Regiment, Captain C.H. Lee. For the Royal Canadian Sea Cadet Corps 195 Bignell, Lieutenant Commander Sean Topsrud, and Chief Petty Officer First Class Trinity Lee. And for the Navy Lee Cadet Corps Miller, Lieutenant Stephen Lemerick, and Coxswain Leading Cadet Jalen Choi. Cadet Corps 2947, Captain Rico Choi, and Regimental Sergeant Major, Chief Warrant Officer Emily Chow. Major Annie May, and Master Warrant Officer, Second Class Thomas Wickens. Six 55 Royal Canadian Air Cadet Squadron, Captain Alex Fong, and Master Warrant Officer, First Class Matthew Lee. Six 92 BCIT Aerospace Royal Canadian Air Cadet Squadron, Captain Greg Dowler, and Warrant Officer, First Class Tiffany Chan. For BC Emergency Health Services, Nahum Ip. Michael Ho and Angus Sang. Richmond Civic Employees Union Local 718, Dal Benning, and a representative from the BC Government Employees Union. We now invite Parade Commander, Warrant Officer William Reed, Color Party Commander Chris Chan, and Veterans Platoon Commander Martin Dash to place their poppies on the field of honor. The Army, Navy, and Air Force Veterans in Canada, Unit 284 Steveston, will be open at noon to parade participants, veterans, and their guests. The public is invited after 1 p.m. We request that the general public remain clear of the cenotaph area as additional community organizations will be invited to lay wreaths in the next few minutes. An announcement will be made when the general public may approach the cenotaph. This brings to a close our Remembrance Day formalities. Would you please rise and join the Richmond Community Band and vocalist Iris Chan in the singing of God Save the King.
Oh, Take me a while
to
catch
you. Yeah.
I'm going to go in. Yeah, I can get through there to the other side.
I don't know. I don't think there are people running through that because they got the whole thing closed
up. Okay. I'll go down this way.
Thanks for your
You bet. Oh, my pleasure.